A little Christmas in July here for Browns YouTubers like myself, because Andrew Barry, who watches the show very closely, was deciding, you know what, it's been a little bit dry lately. Let's get a news dump out there, and the Browns signed a player and waived a player. So we're going to break down these moves in today's video before we go live in a few short hours. But Brad Steinbrook was the first one I saw who broke the news, tweeting out that the Browns have signed cornerback Thakarius BoPete and waived center Dawson Deaton with an injury designation. Now, hand up, I had never heard of Mr. Keys before, so we're going to get to know him together here. He was a former seventh-round draft pick by the Kansas City Chiefs coming out of Tulane back in 2020. His nickname is BoPete, but we got to give him credit. Thakarius is one of the best names I have ever seen. Now, he has lived out of his suitcase. He's been bouncing around the NFL since joining the league back in 2020. Last year, he was on four different practice squads, three different teams, one team, two stints. So he definitely knows a thing or two about adjusting to a new system and rolling with the punches and picking up a new playbook and trying to get it in his head as quickly as possible. Now, there's not a whole lot of stats out there on Mr. Keys in his career. Just 13 games played. A majority of that came in his first season with the Kansas City Chiefs. He has one start under his belt, but he has had NFL regular experience with the Chicago Bears and the Indianapolis Colts. Now, the cornerback depth chart doesn't really change a whole lot for me. Keys does not join this room and take someone's spot, at least not in my eyes. Denzel Ward, Martin Emerson, Greg Newsome, AJ Green, Cam Mitchell, they're all locks to make this roster. I like Thomas Graham a lot. I think he's a really good kind of slot corner. So is Michael Ford, who honestly doesn't get a ton of traction on the airwaves, but he's a sneaky good signing the Browns had for special teams as well. So even after adding Keys, unless an injury pops up, which, by the way, why did they sign a cornerback, right? I know that this is a big conspiracy theory that I'm kind of creating out of nothing here, but none of us really thought they were going to sign a corner. So it does make you wonder if something were to happen to another cornerback during some off-season workouts and they gave Andrew Barry a call and he's like, all right, well, I'm short one corner. I've already got an injured center. Let's just make some roster moves here and get another camp body to run the DB drills. Maybe I'm completely making something out of nothing here, but I definitely did not think cornerback was a position that Cleveland would want to add to before training camp got underway. Honestly, if I had to rank all the positions from most likely to least likely, cornerback would be right there towards the bottom with quarterback and maybe even offensive line. So with that, let's look a little bit closer at Keys' career. Like I said, he got started with the Chiefs in 2020, waived after one season, went over to the Colts for a brief stint, Patriots practice squad, then up to Chicago, and then last year, four different stints on practice squads, the Texans twice, the Falcons, and most recently with the Baltimore Ravens right before the season ended. Now, we have to just address the elephant in the room here. This is a name straight out of a Key and Peele skit. So what is the best name in the NFL? I think it's Thakarius BoPete Keys. I don't know what else is going to beat that. Let me know if you got a better name in the comment section, because this one, when I saw that, I was like, all right, I don't know anything about this guy. I'm already a fan of his because this is an all-time name here. Now, before we get on with the rest of the show and talk about Dawson Deaton, we have a live show coming up in just a few short hours. So make sure to subscribe, turn on your notifications so you don't miss it. If you've never tuned in for a live Browns report, it's a ton of fun. You can join this one on Thursday, 5 o'clock Eastern, 4 o'clock Central, and have it be your first, and I bet you'll be coming back every single week. We have a lot of fun breaking down all the latest on the Cleveland Browns. It's interactive. There's a lot of great reasons. Click onto today's show to find out why. Once again, 5 p.m. Eastern today. Now, Dawson Deaton was the corresponding roster move made to open up a spot for Mr. Keys. Another seventh-round pick, this time by the Browns, coming out in 2021 from Texas Tech, or 2022, I think. Now, he tore his ACL during training camp this past year. The Browns released him with an injury designation. So all that really means is that the rest of the NFL knows Dawson Deaton is not healthy. Like we said, tore his ACL during training camp last year in the middle of August. Never saw him play a single snap in the regular season. I can't even remember if he even played much in the preseason. If he did, probably just like a quarter or two against the Jags in that first preseason game. But outside of that, very little tape on Deaton, who had some good accolades when he was with the Texas Tech Red Raiders, but in the NFL, not a whole lot. The Browns' offensive line depth chart doesn't really change a whole lot, especially at the center position. You already have Ethan Posick, Nick Harris, and Luke Whipler. Like, you are pretty deep at center. I'm going to speculate that Harris and or Whipler will be a guard this year, technically, because not many teams carry three true centers, but they want some versatility and flexibility. So you're already pretty loaded at center. You drafted one this year in Luke Whipler. The writing was sort of on the wall for Dawson Deaton, and it looks like that ACL injury last year was just not recovering quick enough for the Browns' liking, and they decided to make a move. Now, when it comes to future moves that may be made by Andrew Berry, I think running back, defensive tackle, and linebacker are still the top three positions. But we kind of saw with the Browns today, they are always unpredictable. Not many people saw the Za'Darius Smith trade coming. Not many people saw this signing happening or a cornerback being signed for that matter. So I think running back and defensive tackle will be ones to watch for over the next few weeks going into training camp. And then linebacker is one once they get training camp underway and the injured linebackers, Anthony Walker, Taki Taki, Jacob Phillips, JOK, they all meet with the trainers. The trainers meet with Andrew Berry. He gets a bit of a report card, a health update on everyone, a status check. He goes, okay, so we're not going to have so-and-so and so-and-so for the next 2 to 3 weeks. Let's go out and sign a linebacker. That is it for today's show. But first things first, we're going to pick a card. We have producer Jack Lauderay behind the camera today, plus one of the two new guys, Jake Chipper, who was wearing his Clemson Orange Bowl t-shirt, and Brown Tiger, you're like this. Had to give him a good hard time about that one with Tennessee and the Joe Milton show hoisting the oranges after that in Miami. But, Mr. Lauderay, no producer has gotten this correct. It's 2v1.
Yeah, I know. There's a lot riding on this.
Can you get your first title? What are we thinking?
Give me a 10 of clubs.
10 of clubs, okay. Mr. Chipper?
I'm going to go 4 of spades.
4 of spades. The 4 of clubs, I think, is the most commonly guessed one. So 4 of spades is right next door. I will go with the ace of diamonds. Ace of diamonds. Okay. One last cut for good measure. So close. King of diamonds. That's the one I got it on, too, almost a month ago.